Guy Carumba. There will be a total lunar eclipse on April 14 to 15. Unlike with a solar eclipse, no special eye protection is needed to enjoy a lunar eclipse. You just need clear enough weather. Most of the eclipse will happen on the morning of the 15th in the Americas. For many people in the Pacific, it'll start on the evening of the 14th and end after midnight. West of the international dateline, it'll be the evening of the 15th. The action starts at 04:53 Universal Time when the moon enters the Earth's penumbra, or outer shadow. You won't see the difference right away, but in 20 minutes or a half hour, the moon will look a little orange. The partial phase starts at 05:58 when part of the moon enters the umbra, or central shadow. A dark gray or brown zone will cross the moon and completely cover it starting at 07:06, which is the beginning of totality. For more than an hour, the moon will be totally eclipsed. You actually may see subtle differences in color across the moon's disk caused by a little sunlight refracting through Earth's atmosphere and reaching the lunar surface. At 08:24, part of the moon heads out of the central shadow. It's very much like the first half of the eclipse, but in reverse. All of the moon is out of the central shadow at 09:33. That's when we say the partial phase has ended. All that's left is the harder-to-see penumbral phase. It ends at 10:37. If you could be on the moon during an eclipse like this, you would see an eclipse of the sun. When people on Earth are seeing the penumbral phase of the lunar eclipse, you would actually see the sun sticking out from behind the Earth. And during totality, the Earth would completely block the sun. At all times, you would see a ring of orange around the Earth as the sun shines through Earth's atmosphere. If you need help converting Universal Time to your own time zone, go to skycarumba.com or follow Sky Carumba on Facebook, Twitter, or Google+, and ask for help. Sky Carumba!